Alright, hey guys, what's going on? It's your boy Daniel here, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you how to make this effect that's on screen right now. It's basically when your crosshair distracts your opponent, and yeah, I think it's pretty cool. And without further ado, let's get started. Alright, so you're going to want to start off by just importing this crosshair PNG right here. It'll be linked in the description as per usual, so go ahead and download that. Now, once you have imported it into Sony Vegas, you're going to want to go and click on the hamburger icon right here, go to compositing mode, and click on add. And right here, you're going to see it removes all the black color right here. And now, inside the clip, you're going to want to go to the place where you can actually see the opponent. Let's see here. Right there. So we're going to want to mark there, and we can drag that there. And now we're going to want to go to where the clip, or where the kill is, rather. And that would be right there. And we can go ahead and do that. So now we're going to go ahead and shrink it. So you go on to cropping and you just drag this out right here. And you know, it's up to you how big you want the crosshair to be, but you know, just make it not too big because it'll look weird. I think that looks good, maybe a bit smaller even. Like that, just perfect. And make sure that's on your first keyframe right here so that it doesn't move for no reason. And there is actually two ways to do this. You can go to Bezier masking right here, but that's not actually what we're gonna do because it's actually pretty inconsistent. Rather, Sony Vegas Pro 16 does not have the best tracking, the Bezier masking right here. If you want to figure out by yourself how you're gonna want to do this, you can go ahead and do that. But I'm gonna be showing you the track motion method, which is, you know, way more reliable, and it takes a bit more time, like a couple minutes, but it's not that much at all. So you just open track motion by clicking on the hamburger icon right there, and you're gonna want to zoom in and just create a preset. And right here, we're gonna want to go to the next frame, and we're gonna want to move this big square right here to where the head is. So 1, 2, 3, and we can correct it again. 1, 2, 3, and there we go. 1, 2, 3, there we go. Yeah, I'm just gonna fast forward this because it's pretty tedious, but you get the idea. You go 3 frames forward and you readjust the crosshair so that it places perfectly on the head. And if the head doesn't move all too much, you just create a keyframe without moving. 1, 2, 3. And yeah, 1, 2, 3. And yeah, you just keep doing this, and I will see you guys when it's done. Alright, now I'm finished with all the keyframing of the track motion and shit like that. So it actually ended up looking like this. I'm just gonna go ahead and mute it. As you can see, very accurate. I'm actually just gonna do that, and I'm gonna make it good full, I think. Just like that. And as you can see, crosshair tracks perfectly on the head. It is a bit laggy. Let me actually just go ahead and pre-render this really quickly. It'll only take a couple seconds, but as you can see, it didn't even fucking work. Okay, brilliant. But as you can see, it just perfectly tracks the head, and in my opinion, it's a very cool effect. I haven't seen too many people use it. I actually haven't seen anyone use it. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to smash that like button, and also consider subscribing, as I do upload these kinds of videos multiple times per week. And yeah, we'll see you guys in probably tomorrow, actually. And yeah, peace.